Hello and welcome to another episode of the Tron Dog Whisperer. And today we're going to be featuring this lovely lady in the middle. Ooh, right there. Her name is Bossy. Sit down. Ken's down. And I'm going to be taking you through another version of dog-on-dog aggression and some of the things that you can do to address it. So before that, these guys have had a nice long walk. They were all really good, and we're going to let them have some fun and go play. There we go. So Bossy is I believe she's about 6 or 7, I could be wrong. She's a German Shepherd Rottweiler mix, and she belongs to a couple of really good friends of mine who've had her for a long time. And you know, she's staying with me this weekend because unfortunately she had an incident with the in-laws and their dog that they have there, and she got into a couple fights, and well, there's no way to say it, she's just not welcome anymore. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna use Bossy, and I'm gonna use her as an example of how you can deal with dog on dog aggression. Again, I've said this before, aggression is never a problem in and of itself. It is the result of a problem. So, come on, Moose. So we're going to use Bossy as an example. There's lots of reasons why dogs fight, and I can't cover them all in one video. When I have specific examples, it gives me a good opportunity to take you through some of the different scenarios when it comes to, you know, dogs and why they fight, and you know, what you can do about it. So Bossy, you can see she's a big girl, she's a big playful girl, she's about 85 pounds though, really powerful dog, and she looks quite intimidating looking, I guess, to some people, but to me she's a big sweetheart. Bossy is one of my favorite dogs on this planet besides my own. I love her to bits. I mean, she's just a great dog. But she does act differently when she's not around me. So I'm going to give you a bit of background as far as I understand it, and I'm going to take you through a few steps of what I would do or what I would recommend doing to resolve the situation. So as far as I know, she started a couple fights with my friend's in-law's dog. I'm not exactly sure what the details were, but basically if Bossy is to go to the in-law's place, she has to be put on muzzle, and I don't have any problem with the use of muzzles. However, you can't keep a dog on a muzzle for, you know, 2-3 days kind of thing. And, you know, it's not really healthy, and it's not really a solution to the problem. So when I did some digging around and started to understand what was going on, the more I heard about it, the more it kind of, the clues started to come in. So basically, the other dog is really dominant from everything that I've gathered in terms of information. Come on, Moose. Hurry up. Let's go. Go play. So I asked a good friend of mine, and, you know, asked her a few questions about this other dog. And it turns out the other dog is in charge. She's in the leadership position. And anytime you have a dog that's in the leadership position in terms of their position within the family, you're going to have problems. And you're going to have altercations with other dogs. And the lead up to a fight is really subtle, and unless you're an expert in dog behavior, it's very difficult to tell exactly, you know, who started what and who triggered what. But at the end of the day, to be honest, it doesn't matter. So if two dogs have a fight, your job as humans involved with those dogs is to resolve the problem, not to point fingers or point blame, assess blame. Because I know it sounds kind of weird, but dogs fighting is a natural behavior. So it's not uncommon, and it's not that, you know, odd for them to do. I mean, they are predators, they are pack animals, they will fight for a number of reasons, but it doesn't mean that they mean ill intent or are mean dogs or aggressive dogs. You can see Boss is a big baby. Hey, Boss, come on. Come here. Good girl. Hey, are you big sweetie? Everybody who meets her completely falls in love with her when she's with me. So, I mean, you can tell, like, look at that face. Like, she's not an aggressive dog, but she does have that kind of thing inside her, like all dogs do. So regardless of how the fight came about, and this is good advice for anybody, if your dog has a fight or is involved in some sort of altercation, the best thing that you can do is figure out a solution. Those are just play growls. And I'm going to use Bossy as an example. So Tara, CM, this one's for you. I hope that your in-laws will be open to this because, you know, spending time with the family and getting to travel is a great thing. Obviously, I don't mind taking care of her and I love her to bits, but, you know, it'd be great if you could have the freedom and the trust to be able to take Bossy anywhere that you want to go with her without worrying. So here's my suggestion. Whenever you have two dogs that aren't getting along for whatever reason, the first thing to do is to take them for a walk. I sound like a broken record, but walk is such a important tool for dogs. It has huge meaning and significance to them. So it helps them to build relationships with dogs that they might not know, or even dogs that they've had fights with. So the other dog that she got involved with, you know, is way out in front on the walks. And if, you know, Bossy and this other dog could walk together beside the humans, in a position where they could get to know each other and build a relationship, then the two dogs would, you know, have that bond when they were done. Now, one walk is good, but it'll probably take several walks for them to really strengthen that bond to the point where there isn't any real need for them to have any fights. The other thing is really, you know, if you're still worried about them having, you know, altercations or whatever, keep the leashes on them. in the house and around wherever they are, and you can monitor their behavior. Now, I know at a family gathering, you don't want to sit there and monitor the behavior of your dogs. You want to enjoy the company of your family and friends, and you know, this is Thanksgiving weekend, so I'm sure there's lots of stuff going on. So what I would recommend is making a special trip just for the dogs. So especially when it's family that's concerned, you know, it's worth it. You can, you know, set aside a weekend or, you know, a couple days, and that would be the purpose of the visit, is to get the dogs to build that relationship so that in future, you know, Bossy could come along instead of staying behind. I mean, the idea behind dogs, and I say this all the time, is dogs should bring people together, not keep them apart. And yeah, it's not keeping the family apart, but the dog isn't involved, you know what I mean? So their son Theo just adores Bossy. Her actual name is Bosco, but everybody calls her Bossy. So he's got to be, their son has to be without his dog for a whole weekend, which, okay, it's not the end of the world, but at the same time, to separate a little boy from his dog, you know, it breaks my heart. And as much as I love Bossy and I'd love to steal her, you know, the bond between a boy and his dog, I mean, I grew up with dogs and I understood, I used to miss my dog terribly whenever they were gone. So that's the first thing to do, is just to walk them together. Another activity that you can do with them is feeding them together. And again, this is something that you would supervise and monitor. But those kind of things are very important to each other. Don't worry, she's tough. She just tripped. Oh, there you go. Oh, what are you limping now? That happens. So the thing is, like, even though Kenzie's limping, like, I'm not going to make a big deal out of it because she's fine. Okay, walk it off. There you go. So if you, it's interesting that happened. I wasn't planning on it, obviously. But if a dog, your dog gets hurt, it's important not to make a big deal out of it because that's actually what causes trauma. So at the end of the day, guys, the number one tip that I have when it comes to dealing with your dog and any type of aggressive behavior is address it. If you don't address the problem, it will continue to get worse. And you're going to start avoiding more and more situations, and that's just going to cause more and more aggravation for you and your dog. So dogs fight. It's not that big of a deal. 99% of the time, it's not like they're going to kill each other or anything like that. They're just, it sounds a lot worse than it is, and there's lots of teeth involved and growling and, you know, some barking and stuff, but it's not that big of a deal. So number one thing, spend lots and lots of time walking dogs together before you just let them interact with each other. I mean, what happens is this other dog is dominant. Therefore, it thinks it owns the house and all the people that are in it. When another dog comes into that environment, there's going to be problems. And whenever you have problems, Like, I could have predicted that there's going to be problems a long time before that ever happened. So, understand the situation that you're in. Understand the dog that you're going to be taking your dog to meet. If there's any question as to what position the other dog holds, just ask the relative or whoever it is a few questions. And as soon as you start to ask those questions, you'll start to get an idea of what may occur, what potential there is, and then what you should do about it. So in this case, every question that I asked led to the same conclusion, in that the other dog was completely dominant and claimed the people and did all kinds of stuff. Come on, go play. Come on, Kens, go play. So it wasn't any surprise to me. So the reality is, in Bossy's specific situation, if I had to guess, and obviously I wasn't there, but it was the other dog that caused the fight, not her. I mean, if you have a dominant dog in its own environment, like this dog is, who has free reign of the house, you introduce another dog to it, and there's a high, high probability that there's going to be problems. So that's my last kind of thought on that. I know it's not super easy, and in any of these scenarios that you're dealing with your dog and you're having difficulties, engage the support and advice of a professional who really understands dog behavior if you're really having difficulty with it. But don't just leave it. Do something about it. Make it better. Make a change. Address it. And then you can move on from that instead of leaving that as the current situation. Now, if I wasn't able to take Bossy, I'm sure they would be able to find somebody else to take her for the weekend. But the reality is that it's not really ideal for the family. And it also creates that mistrust between the family and their dog. So, you know, that's a really sad thing. Anyway, I know this is a long video, guys. I'll try to keep them shorter next time. But again, it's a really complex subject. And, you know, I know a lot of people are having problems with this type of subject. So I want to take the time to address it. Till next time. Come on. Mosley, come. Sit down. We gotta do our outro. Sit. Mosley's the slow man. So Bossy and Mackenzie and Mosley. Sit. I'll say, if you love your dog, if you love your dog, if you love your dog, take them for a walk. Till next time. Walk? Bossy? Wanna go for a walk? Have a great day. Bye-bye.